Good morning. I want to welcome you all to Moores Bridges Water Treatment Plant and our 150th anniversary celebration. My name is Jordan Stokes and I have the honor of being your host today. And we're going to go ahead and get things started with our first speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Mayor Kenneth Cooper Alexander to the stage.
I'm joined by my colleague on the Norfolk City Council, Mamie Johnson, City Manager Pat Roberts, Deputy City Manager Krista Pope, and Doug Beaver. Thank you for being here. It's a pleasure to join you to commemorate this important milestone, 150 years of water service from Norfolk's oldest water treatment facility. In 1873, Moores Bridges pumped its first gallon of water to Norfolk residents. To have a long-standing water operation and one of the oldest in the country is an extraordinary achievement. It's without a doubt that Moores Bridges is the centerpiece of Norfolk's expansive water system. A lot has changed in the last century, but one thing hasn't changed: the importance of having clean and safe, reliable drinking water. And I want to extend my appreciation to the men and women of Norfolk Utilities for your dedication and your commitment. Our economy depends on it. Manufacturing depends on it. Farming, tourism, recreation, energy production, and other economic sectors need clean water to function and flourish. As the second largest water distributor in the Commonwealth of Virginia, Moores Bridges Water Treatment Facility serves nearly 250,000 residents and businesses and nearly 1 million consumers throughout the region. Norfolk's reputation for providing clean and reliable drinking water is a direct result of an unwavering commitment of our utility professionals. Can we give them a huge round of applause? And just to add, our utilities won the American Water Works Association's Best Tasting Tap Water in Virginia Award for two consecutive years as a true testament to the unparalleled efforts of this department. Thank you all for what you do for our citizens each and every day, and congratulations to those who are being recognized for serving our city for 10 to 20 years. Your loyalty and dedication to our citizens is exceptional and inspiring. We look forward to the next 150 years of high quality clean water in our city and our region. Thank you.
Most folks want to know the first question off the gate is, why is this called Moores Bridges? This property used to be the farm of Cason Moore, and he had bridges over two streams that were tributary to Broad Creek. Those streams were dammed up in the 1870s, and we now know them as Lake Wright and Lake Taylor. Although this facility got started in 1873, there were some attempts to build a consolidated water system in addition to just the well that was downtown. The Navy began that proposal looking at the Northwest River in the 1840s. They also looked at Lake Drummond. In 1865, the city put it to a vote and the citizens voted to approve a loan of $500,000 to build the waterworks. Not everybody was on board. And according to one of the local newspapers, a comment came in that said, "No water fit for human stomach can be had from any of the sources named, nothing more than a den of snakes and all kinds of water insects." Luckily, we persevered, and in 1873, Lake Wright and Lake Taylor were created by damming up those streams, and Moores Bridges came online along with Lake Lawson, which is about 5 miles to the east of here in Virginia Beach. That water was piped here. And keep in mind that up until 1899, it was straight lake water. There was no treatment. So straight out of the lake to the homes downtown. Between 1873 and 1899, the water system expanded greatly, adding 6 reservoirs in Princess Anne County. They dammed up the area between Lake Lawson and Lake Smith, two Moores Bridges, and created what we now call the Arendtown Reservoir System. And the next big expansion occurred because of World War II. World War I. In the 1920s, following a severe drought, Lake Prince was constructed in Suffolk and a pipeline laid, and what we then called the 37th Street Water Treatment Plant was built, what we now call the Kristen M. Lenz Water Treatment Plant. It was expanded again in the 40s due to World War II. The Navy came to the city and said, we now use 1.5 million gallons a day. We're gonna need 10. Temporary lines were run from the Dismal Swamp Canal to Stumpy Lake to supplement the supply while Lake Burnt Mills was constructed in Suffolk and connected to Lake Prince, which still went to the 37th Street Water Treatment Plant. And during that time, we also purchased the Norfolk County Water Company. Blackwater and Nottoway Rivers were independently researched by the Federal Works Agency and connected to the headwaters of Lake Prince to ensure that the Navy had that water. After that, the Federal Works Administration Agency sold all of that to Norfolk. In the 60s was the next expansion, Western Branch Reservoir, and four deep wells were installed, and that was the first time that pipelines brought Suffolk water here to Moores Bridges. In 1997, Virginia Beach connected the Lake Gaston supply. In 2001, we sold Stumpy Lake to Virginia Beach, still connected to our system. And today, we supply water to all of Norfolk, Virginia Beach, parts of the city of Chesapeake. We have connections to the city of Portsmouth for drought relief, the Western Tidewater Water Authority, and all the Department of Defense installations on the south side.
Hello, everyone, again, and welcome to the celebration of 150 years of the Norfolk Water System and Moores Bridges. For the past century and a half, utilities has been providing continuous water service, and as we all now know, it has now grown into a regional water provider for 1 million people. This is our mid-year service recognition ceremony, and I could think of no better occasion than today's events to acknowledge some of the 400 utility team members that helped make this happen. In a moment, we're going to call up those who are being recognized. I invite the mayor and council members to come up front and help with the presentation. For those receiving service recognition, please come up to the podium for your award when you hear your name.
These are certificates of 5 years of service.
Tiba Salim. Next is Terrell Britt. Next is Sean Bales.
These are 10 years now. James Joseph Rhodes.
Next is Randy Holloman.
Next
is Claude Stone. Next is John Phelps.
Next is Gina Shaw.
Next is Francis Covarrubia. Next is Tony Collins.
Sorry, we've moved on to 15 years, by the way.
15.
Starting with Gina. Gabriel Phelps.
Next is Shante Evans.
And our last recipient with 35 years of service, Nathan Cooley.